This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to fix the please enter privacy protection password on your MTK Android phone. You usually get this message when you remove the SIM card from your phone, and it's common with the new wave of MTK Android phones which are being released. So for you to fix this, you need SP Flash 2 and you need the stock backup, this SP Flash 2 and the stock backup for that particular phone model. It needs to be the exact phone model so you don't run into trouble. Now, before you can use SP Flash, you need to have installed your VCOM drivers. So you can check our website for the tutorial on how to manually install VCOM drivers. Now, once you have your VCOM drivers installed, you can now proceed with SP Flash 2. Now, I took a screenshot of my phone here. I have a phone having this particular same issue, an M3. When you boot the phone, all it's going to write is, please enter privacy protection password to unlock, and it's just going to keep giving you that. Factory reset does nothing, hard reset zero, just keeps doing the same thing. So you are going to be fixing using SP Flash 2. Now, after installing VCOM drivers, what you want to do is launch SP Flash 2 as admin to avoid any permission issues. Now, the first thing you want to do in SP Flash 2 is to format the phone. Now, it's very important you do not format unless you have the stock backup to flash back to the phone. You understand why I'm saying this in a few minutes. Now, in SP Flash 2, you click on scatter loading, you go to where the stock backup is, select the scatter file, and then scatter file is loaded. Now, to format, you click on format, leave it on auto format flash, and format whole flash except bootloader, then you click on start. Now, at this point, you go to the phone, remove the battery from the phone, slot it back in, but don't power on the phone. Now, in this state, what you now do is to connect the phone to the PC via USB cord. While it is switched off and with the battery inside, connect to the PC. Now, this is SP Flash version 5. It could be quite slow, so very important to just be patient and give it time to do its thing. Try not to interrupt SP Flash 2, else the phone will just go totally dead. Alright, so after formatting, you would notice that the phone is totally dead, no power, no nothing. You press the power button, the max you might get is a vibration, and the phone is just going to stay dead. Don't worry, it's part of the plan. Now, at this point, we are now going to flash the stock backup to the phone. Now, if you didn't have the stock backup and you went ahead to format, you are kind of in a fix at this point because your phone is totally dead and you have no stock backup to flash back to the phone. That's why I asked you not to format unless you have the stock backup. So we have the stock backup here, so we are going to proceed with flashing it. I click on scatter loading, select the scatter file. Now these are the ones that are ticked. I proceed with flashing. Now I leave it on download only and I click download. Now I already created the tutorial on how to use SP Flash 2. You might want to see that for more information. Not be going in depth, just going straight to the point in this tutorial. So at this point now, I'm ready to flash the files to my phone. So what I do again is remove the battery, slot back in, but don't boot, don't press the power button. At this point, I connect the phone to the PC via USB cord and just keep watching. It might look like nothing is happening, so you might be tempted to close it and restart. It's very important to be patient, just let it flash. Keep watching, keep waiting. Do not interrupt SP Flash 2. And if accidentally, okay, flashing has begun. And if you accidentally interrupt SP Flash 2, nothing much to panic about. All you have to do is just keep charging the phone, take out the battery, slot it back in. If the battery is not removable, just keep charging and just keep charging. Reinstall VCOM drivers and just keep charging for quite some hours. And you know that could be quite a headache, so it's very important you just avoid that by not interrupting SP Flash 2. So once flashing is complete, I'm expecting to get a green OK circle. I can close that and boot my phone, and everything is going to work fine again. Now it's very important you ensure there's a formatted memory card in the phone during this process. I forgot to mention that, because some phones actually require you to have a memory card for them to work fine. So it's important to format a memory card and slot into the phone before this whole flashing process. And after flashing the phone, if you boot the phone and it's still stuck at logo, that is the brand logo, all you need to do is boot into recovery mode. You can Google how to boot your particular modem to recovery mode. Now in recovery mode, just go to wipe data factory reset. You do a factory reset to recovery mode, take out the battery, put it back in, and boot the phone, and everything should work fine again. So what I'm waiting for is my download okay to confirm that flashing is complete, and I can then boot my phone and error will be gone by then. Alright, so my flashing is complete. I have the green circle okay. That shows that it's complete. So now the phone is going to boot up normally and everything should be back to normal. So basically that's how you fix the please enter privacy protection password on your MTK Android phone.